I'm Sophie Ellis-Bexter, and this is behind the scenes at the video for my new single, Bittersweet.
Ready, running playback. How can I deny the feeling? Can't choose the fuse that lights the spark. Don't think I'll hold out too much longer.
The song is called Bittersweet because it's about a love affair that you know is probably going to do you no good, but you can't really help yourself. I wanted to bring about it the positive sides of it. I mean, although the relationship might be a bit naughty, it's essentially mainly nice. Dance music was my first introduction to doing pop in a lot of ways, because before that I was in an indie band, and then I met a DJ when I was 20 and did a song called Groove Jet, and that just opened my mind to this whole other spectrum. And from then on, I call myself a pop star because I think pop lets you tell the story in 3 minutes. This fourth album, essentially, it picks up where the last one left off. I mean, I'm still making pop music, but I think this one is a lot more dance-centric. I think with the last record, it is a little bit more eclectic, whereas this time I've worked with a lot of dance DJs like the Freemasons and Calvin Harris and Metronomy and Liam from the Sneaker Pimps, and it's just a bit more consistently upbeat, I think. I know I shouldn't go, but something makes me crave the heat. Your love is bittersweet. The concept of the video, in essence, is to celebrate the sensual side of the lyric, I suppose. The song is all about a love affair, which is completely made your heart rule your head. So I wanted it to feel sensual and just be about lots of textures, so it's got to be a slight sensory overload.
We're using this camera that shoots in super slow motion, so we're going to throw paint at Sophie, we're going to like blast powder at her, blast petals at her, and all these things that are specifically geared to look really cool on this super slow motion camera. We've kind of got this idea of a good Sophie and a bad Sophie. So one of the looks is very natural and stripped back, quite natural makeup. And then the other one is a bit more kind of fierce. And we've had this huge purple dress made that we can blow wind up inside.
There's three main elements. There's the performance, which I was shooting this morning, which is candid and intimate and supposed to represent, you know, your real feelings about this person and the position you found yourself in. And then there's the dance routine, which is an essential part of a good dance floor filler, I think. And then the third element is this sort of sensory pleasure side of it. I think it's going to look spectacular, actually, because with the slow motion camera, every little detail just looks really gorgeous, and it's a real pleasure to watch something unfold. So watching things like the paint splatter or the glitter in the air or the rose petals. So yeah, I think it'll look very atmospheric. I suppose my main desires for the video for this song was just something that was celebratory, not quite as considered and diva-like as maybe some of the other things I've done, so where you maybe get a slightly different side of me. And so yeah, doing trampolining and hula hooping, my idea of fun. I really like making videos. I know some artists find them a bit of a pain, but I mean, in my opinion, you've made a little song and then people are going to the bother of making a film to accompany your song. I think they can take your relationship with the song to a new level, so I think they're pretty vital, really. I've been lots of trampolining going on this afternoon and lots of having things fired at me. I've had petals, triangles, bubbles, glittery shapes. It's been a really enjoyable day. I've been having lots of fun. So it's great that I also get a video to take home out of it at the end too. And I hope you enjoy watching it.